Hello guys, this is Indian Medico, and in this video we are going to see about complications of spinal and epidural anesthesia. This is a concise presentation for medical students. First, let us see a few points regarding anatomy. The subarachnoid space lies between arachnoid and pyameter. It contains cerebrospinal fluid or CSF. The spinal cord ends at the level of L1 to L2. The iliac crests are at level of L4. Iliac crests are important surface anatomy for spinal and epidural anesthesia. We have to insert needle at L3, L4 or L4, L5. At this level, cauda equina is present and spinal cord has already ended. Now let us see about the indications of spinal and epidural anesthesia. We can use spinal or epidural anesthesia for surgeries of lower extremities, lower abdomen, genitourinary and anal region. Now let us see about the differences between epidural anesthesia and spinal anesthesia. Epidural anesthesia differs from spinal anesthesia in that needle is placed in epidural space in epidural anesthesia, whereas in case of spinal anesthesia, we place the needle in subarachnoid space and inject the anesthetic into the CSF. In case of epidural anesthesia, we inject the anesthetic outside of CSF. In epidural anesthesia, commonly an indwelling catheter is left in place. This can provide continuous anesthesia. We can periodically bolus the catheter for prolonged surgeries in epidural anesthesia. Epidural anesthesia takes longer to obtain effect and requires higher doses when compared to spinal anesthesia. It is also technically more difficult and requires more time to place than spinal anesthesia. Let us see about the complications of these procedures. Hypotension can occur due to sympathetic blockade. It is more common in spinal anesthesia than epidural anesthesia. Nausea can occur due to unopposed parasympathetic activity. Again, it is more common in spinal anesthesia. Post-spinal headache can occur due to CSF leak. It is less common in spinal anesthesia and it occurs only when there is inadvertent dural puncture during epidural placement in epidural anesthesia. Urinary retention is common in both these procedures. Backache is also common in both these procedures. Permanent neurologic injury can occur very rarely during these procedures. Epidural abscess or hematoma can occur rarely during epidural anesthesia. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. For more such videos, please check out my playlists. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.